I'm at grid reference 61 now. Seismic charge 14. Ready for placement. Placing it now. Oh, no. We seem to have some surface instability here.
Don't go poking it around, you idiot. The whole area could be loose. Just leave the charge and get back in here.
Hold on. I think there's something in here.
If it turns out to be you, you're on your own. I'm not digging you out. I'm a surveyor, not a St. Bernard.
Good. God! Look at this.
Look at what? What have you found?
It seems I found what I came to Mars for in the first place. Fame, fortune, and a first-class ticket home.
Welcome to the moon, Mr. Larwood.
Daniel?
Colin Davis. Screen on, file Daniel Larwood. Well, the journalists, we are honoured.
Is that an order or merely a pious hope?
The voice of controversy. If that's booze, that's a big mistake out here.
Mm. It's probably a big mistake anywhere, but then mistakes are what make us human, no?
Out here, mistakes are what make you dead.
Hello, pal. Hey, they told me you're a top cop now, but I stuck up for you anyway, kid.
Still polishing your Pat O'Brien impression, Daniel.
Had to give it up. Couldn't get the accent. Couldn't write like Ben Hecht either, unfortunately.
So you settled for a more general image.
Drunken hack.
May I? Mm. Water.
Water?
Oh, I love a good miracle, don't you?
You always were a phony, Daniel.
Well, what brings you to the moon, Daniel? You were working on a particular story?
I hope so, Colin. Though these days I am, in fact, not that particular.
Will you ever?
Well, your clearances are in order. Have a nice day. Ah.
Use it sparingly, Daniel. You won't find another source out here.
You know, I liked you better as a student, pal.
Well, why wouldn't you? I believed what you said in those days.
Well, I told you I was a journalist.
I believed that, too.
Oh, no blow. You were a disappointment to me, too, you know. I mean, I was quite put down when I realised that you and your friends weren't quite as radical as your reputation suggested.
Well, it was a pity your story didn't say that.
Well, actually, it did. But then, any mention at all of the word anarchist and people always see red.
Keep in touch.
Depend on it.
Water in a hip flask.
The brandy was in his bag.
Yeah, I know. I hate to seem picky, but that is a violation.
Well, he was a friend once. Wouldn't like to see him going blind on shuttle fuel.
You kidding? Those blokes in Maine shuttle repair make their own scotch out of that stuff. It's better than the real thing.
Well, does it seem like a good idea to have a thirsty journalist find that out?
Is that the sort of story he's looking for?
No. Oh, Daniel Larwood doesn't look for stories. He acts strictly on information received.
So you reckon this is something special?
There's something cooking, Colin. There's definitely something cooking.
So that's what a Martian looks like.
Ugly little bugger, isn't he? Can you lift it out?
Now, look, you do understand the risk that we're taking.
We seem to have talked about nothing else since we left Mars. Can we stop wasting time?
Okay, as long as you're sure.
I'm sure I need money.
Well, a picture of that thing is going to be worth a fortune.
Let's get on with it. We're running out of time.
I'm sorry, Alex. You of all people must realize I simply do not have the authority to get rid of this Larwood character. Even if I wanted to.
Why is he here?
Yes, why is he here?
We don't want reporters nosing around.
No?
I have an important guest.
Yes, I know. And how come we weren't informed of that?
Dr. Philpott is here by official invitation. I do not wish him to be harassed.
Goodbye, reporters or ISPF?
Will shift 3 maintenance engineers report to loading bay 9.
Alex, what exactly is it you want?
We are friends, Alina Bevan. Thank you. You trust me, eh? You trust my good intentions?
Yes, well, the road to hell is paved with those.
You will deal with this journalist for me?
Yes, of course.
Good.
If he breaks the law.
I took it for granted that the local constabulary would cooperate more readily than that.
I fear no one likes to be taken for granted, Dr. Philpott. Least of all, come out of spring.
Look, Alexander. Confidentiality is absolutely essential, you realise. Without
we
it,
have,
we're...
We have the cover story, if it is needed.
Yes. And if the press believe it.
Why should they not?
Why should your policeman not do as he was asked?
Drinks machines. They don't improve, do they?
Nice to have something to rely on.
Tell me, Mr. Larwood, just what is your interest in Dr. Philpott?
Have I got one?
Yeah, there's a feeling round here that you might have.
Paranoia, clearly.
But you do know who he is?
He works for the Holy Museum, Southern California.
Yeah. A museum with all the money in the world, eh?
Reputed to have so much, they don't bother counting it anymore. They just take it out from time to time and weigh it. Philpott is one of their 100 or so curators, known collectively as the Bumbling Herd.
Well, not just paranoia, then.
Routine information.
Oh, yes, yes, of course. It's the kind of information you're bound to have on somebody you're not interested in.
Well, I've been doing some stuff on the Holy, as it happens.
Well, well, small moon, isn't it?
A sense of humour. Not that common in policemen, in my experience.
Ah. I was under the impression you found most policemen humorous. Mm-hmm. What was that article that you wrote for Atlas News, wasn't it? A series entitled Cops and Robbers,
Plain Man's Guide to the Differences. Yes, I was working well, didn't you think?
Well, I'm not really qualified to judge.
Oh, several of your colleagues felt qualified to judge. In fact, quite a few of them volunteered to be jury and executioner too. I took to carrying a gun there for a while.
Well, people get carried away.
In body bags. That was the thought that bothered me.
Nothing need worry about out here.
No. You'll protect me.
Yes. And everyone else who stays within the law?
Oh, that sounds like a warning.
Oh, paranoia, clearly.
And academic, perhaps. For I hear off to visit Mars soon, anyway.
Oh. Farewell. More routine information?
Oh, common knowledge, surely. You're off to extend the Star Cop Empire to the rugged pioneers of the Martian colonies.
Yes, yes. I thought it was about time I recruited some little green men.
Oh. Are there any little green men?
So you have heard that rumor, then?
No.
It's just that where there's living, there's policemen, Mr. Larwood.
Can I quote you?
Oh, yes, certainly, you may.
Excuse me, I'm sure you'll think I'm very rude, but aren't you Daniel Larwood?
Yeah, that's right, Miss...
Well, we've never met, but I'm a great admirer of your work.
Oh, thank you. I knew there had to be one, and you don't even look like my mother.
Would you think me very silly if I asked for an autograph?
Well, I'd think you very silly if you didn't.
Who shall I make it to?
Jane.
Ah, to dear Jane, who ain't so plain, Daniel Larwood.
Thank you. I'm sorry to have intruded.
Oh, no, no, worry, no worries, no worries. So, what happens here, then, while you're bringing civilization to Mars?
Well, my second-in-command, David Theroux, he'll be back any day. It's on Earth rest. He'll take over. Nobody's indispensable.
That's usually a good reason for staying put.
Which is something you're not going to do, Mr. Larwood, if I have any complaints about you harassing other visitors.
Oh, I don't harass people for stories, Commander. People come to me with information. I'm a bit like a policeman, really.
I doubt that, Mr. Larwood. I doubt that very much.
What's this supposed to be?
Search me. But it wasn't on the cargo manifest, so it shouldn't have been there.
So it is contraband. Not exactly the major drugs haul you guys came to the moon to intercept, is it?
Don't be like that, Colin. You know we can't ignore Earthside tip-offs. Any more than what you can.
Well, ignoring them's one thing, but a customs task force on the strength of it. Oh, come on.
Well, that's not the reason why.
Where'd you find it?
There, underneath the top layer.
Well, but this stuff's not full moon base, is it?
No. Onward shipment to Mars.
So why the hell were you searching through it?
You live a good life. You can expect a little luck sometimes.
You were fishing.
Listen. Somebody's tender parts are definitely for the chop if we don't start justifying our existence soon.
And, you reckon this'll do it?
Oh, dear.
Supply Shuttle 4, this is Outpost 17. Do you copy? Supply Shuttle 4, this is Outpost 17. Do you copy?
Outpost 17, this is Supply Shuttle 4. I thought we said our goodbyes already. I am a little busy, you know.
That liftoff was rocky. Are you okay?
Lifting off from these things is always rocky. That's why they pay extra to people like me.
I wasn't expecting it to be quite that bad.
I would have thought even you chemical engineering types could recognize a design lash up when you saw one.
We put a lot of work into what you're carrying. It's on the fragile side.
Sorry about that. But if you want it to arrive at main base in time for the next Earth freighter, you'll just have to grin and bear it, won't you?
Not at these prices, I won't.
Wanna bet?
What did he say?
Look, can we stop wasting time? I'm too old, I'm too cold, and I'm too bloody tired for all this.
You're dropping off our radar. Should you be doing that?
Christ!
She's dead.
Yes, killed on impact.
What the hell was she doing there?
Moonlighting. People skilled in the handling of the modified shuttle are at a premium.
So it would seem. Well, frankly, Dr. Gravenko, I am appalled. This could ruin everything.
I'm leaving for Earth immediately. Perhaps I can expedite matters.
I hope so. I assume you realize who'll be blamed for failure.
Only too well, Dr. Philpott. Only too well.
So you think Pilot would be blamed, then?
Too right.
But you don't think it was far forward, do you?
If I was asked to guess, I'd say those boys in shuttle maintenance have been knocking back a few schooners of that home brew of theirs. A few clogged pipes forget to serve as a flight computer. It's little oversights like that can make the difference between flying and bouncing, especially in that modified hopper.
She was young today.
Huh? Moon Rover 5, all systems on automatic.
Look.
Yeah, well, who's ever old enough to die? I don't think I saw her around, did you?
No. A duplicate ID in the same pouch. If she lost one, she would lose them both, you know.
Well, typical shuttle jockey. If they got any brains, I wouldn't be flying those things. Ella?
Yeah?
Do you know when Nathan's actually leaving yet?
I know as little as you.
I just thought you might have heard something.
Why should you think that?
Well, someone's got to take over the second spot to David Theroux's number one.
Yeah, a chief assistant to the assistant chief, huh?
Yeah, well, I just thought you might have got the nod.
No, Nathan will tell us what we need to know at the appropriate time, I expect.
Anna, if I'm honest, I have to say I'm not overly impressed by the Japanese attitude to authority. I mean, I'm sure it makes for terrific termite, but I reckon human beings should think for themselves occasionally.
You know, Kenzie,
huh?
Look what I found.
Well, where did you find it?
Right here, in the packing.
What do you suppose it is? As if we didn't know.
Drugs, you sure?
No, but it's a lot of trouble to go to for powdered beef casserole.
You better bring it on in, then.
Well, that's a good idea. We were planning to stop and dump it over the side.
I meant we can't do anything till you get it here, pal.
Screen off.
There's one bloke who won't get the second spot anyway.
Calling you, he's not as stupid as he liked to pretend, you know.
How could he be?
Meantime, rumors persist that something astounding has been discovered on Mars and is even now on its way to the moon base for eventual transshipment to Earth. No one seems to know what the discovery is, only that it could be something which will change forever the way man sees himself. Is this just another of those instant myths which is suddenly forgotten? Or is there really a secret being kept from us by
Sound
cautious
off.
Authorities?
I was listening to that.
No, you weren't. You were thinking dirty thoughts.
Anything wrong with nostalgia?
Now, listen. You're looking at stuff coming from Earth to Moonbase, yeah?
Yeah.
You checking stuff going the other way?
Well, back to her?
Yeah. No. Thought as much.
Why? Someone growing opium poppies in the hydroponics plant.
Close.
You're not serious.
Oh, yes, I am. Sound on.
This is Cosmopolitan News, and my name is Susan Caxton.
Thanks, Colin. I was looking forward to missing that.
Daniel Larwood. You have some merchandise for me?
Hey! What's the matter with you, man?
I did. What? Did.
Did you know the dead man?
No.
But you were there to meet him?
No.
Oh, you just happened to be in one of the more deserted areas at one of the quieter times when there just happened to be a murder.
How else could I have reported it?
Well, you seem to know your way around pretty well for a beginner. Did you touch the body at all?
No.
Not even to see if he was dead?
Oh, yes, well, I did.
Oh, that. Yes, well, then you did touch the body. What did you take?
Like what?
The pockets were empty.
I gave up grave robbing when I took up journalism.
It's a point of view.
Mm. All right, Mr. Larwood, you can go.
That it then?
For the time being.
But, don't leave town, right?
You can't. You've got a lot to learn, Larwood. Out here, there's nowhere else to go. And another thing. It doesn't rain on the moon.
Look, there's definitely something cooking, mate. I know that man.
Yeah, he's lying through his teeth. Are we keeping tabs on him?
What do you think?
Box, have you got me anything on that dead shuttle pilot yet?
There is no record of her arrival on Moonbase, and no record of her presence here.
Thank you, Box. Why not? Why is there no record of her presence here?
Well, I suppose if they're smuggling drugs out, they could be smuggling people in.
It's possible.
Do you ever get the feeling things are out of control?
Well, they better not be.
It's a joke.
Listen, when I go for Mars, you know, I do not expect to see this place fall apart.
You won't. There's no video link between here and Mars. Screen on.
Listen, push Central Registry for an ID on the dead man and hurry up that autopsy report. We need it as soon as possible. I'm going to find out about the dead girl.
Maybe there's a connection.
Suggest one.
Well, they were both in the wrong place at the wrong time, that's for sure.
And circumstantial, Kenzie.
Oh, okay, I'm working on it.
I'm just the operations manager. How the hell would I know where she came from?
She was flying one of your modified shuttles.
Well, she was qualified. There aren't many of them around here.
Yes, well, there's one less now.
Oh, shit. Okka, that Martian stuff on 3-4 should be loading now.
It's loading.
Transferred the work order.
I did.
Oh, well, never mind. Just get them back onto it. Do you read me?
They're onto it, yeah.
We're maximising Mars traffic and they're wasting time on Earth freight. Do you know what a window of opportunity is?
Yes, well, I know the Mars is closer at the moment. I'm going there myself soon.
Well, take my advice. Go there now. Chaos is coming. Go now, please.
Look, this planetary conjunction kind of taken you by surprise. I mean, it's a predictable event, isn't it? Just like people.
People pushing for priority Earth transfers. The latest shuttle requests are impossible. Lucky press, what do they think they're running here? Some stupid rumours about little green men, and I'm up to my neck in panicking idiots.
Look, the dead pilot, where did you get her?
Why are you wasting what little time and sanity I have left asking stupid questions about some unlucky shuttle jockey?
Because she might be some unlucky drugs runner. Now, will you leave those buttons alone and stop wasting my time?
Okka, come and take over. Drugs runners? What drugs?
Where did you get her?
She was just a freelance looking to pick up a bit of extra cash. There's nothing unusual in that.
Excepting there's no record of her presence here.
Isn't there?
You didn't check?
Well, why should I? She was here. She was a registered pilot. She was in temporary guest quarters. What more would I need to know?
temporary guest quarters. Box. Visual record.
Access to Moonbase?
I have given no such order. Indeed, I am in no position to give such an order.
You mean when you go back to the moon, we can all go with you? Is that what you're saying?
Much as I enjoy your company, gentlemen and ladies, especially the ladies.
Oh boy. He's really got that everyone's cuddly uncle routine down pat, hasn't he?
Not as cuddly as me, though, is he?
This news already had
the came through on that dead man. There was a connection, or coincidence.
Yeah, what is it?
He was a pilot, too. And there's no record of him being on Moonbase either.
Yeah, it makes sense. Listen, I think they're sharing the same quarters, which have just been turned over, by the way.
Sir, Dr. Trevenko, sir, is it really a little green man, sir?
Think he knows?
Somebody does.
Yeah, I don't know why they're playing it so cagey, though.
Spin off.
Hey, don't break that, Kenzie. I've got plans for that.
Break it? You do know what this is, don't you?
Yeah, it's contraband. It's way to Mars.
Question is, why?
Boy, you really don't know, do you?
I'm not in the mood for riddles, Kenzie.
Well, I'd say there's some collector in the Martian colonies doesn't want to pay punitive freight rates for something that's already cost him an arm and a leg. If it's real.
It's real what?
Pre-Columbian sculpture.
Is that what it is?
Well, I'd say it was Mayan, which would make it, what, 2,000 years old?
You'd, say it was Mayan.
I took art as well as engineering.
What, you're an art expert?
Oh, don't let it throw you. And the course did include creative spitting and spray can for beginners, as well as pre-Columbian art.
Right. All right.
Why are you so touchy?
I'm not touchy.
Yeah, you're giving a pretty good imitation of it.
Is this the one?
It's the one.
I don't like to be laughed at, that's all.
I'm not laughing at you.
Well, you were giving a pretty good imitation of it.
Any more cases like this in the cargo?
One or no?
Well, just so long as our quarry knows which one to come for and I know which one to watch.
Well, it's fairly expensive bait. I hope you realise.
Second level, right?
Right.
Christ, don't do that!
Oh, it's perfectly safe. They're seismic test charges.
They're explosives, you silly bitch!
Only if they're primed.
What's the matter with you?
I don't like to be called names.
Ah, a death before dishonour? Well, absolutely.
I'm an engineer, as it happens. I do know what I'm doing. Now, these things can't be set off except with a microwave fuse, which I believe are in this box here. Do you want to see one?
No. Thank you.
Had your fun, Kenzie.
Sir?
Is this the cargo loader for this lot?
Yeah, it goes up to Lucifer One. I'll keep you informed if there are any changes in the loading schedule.
Yeah, I don't want to end up on the wrong freighter.
No problem.
You'll have to excuse my friend. She doesn't know which side she's on.
Well, not me. I'm on the side that found the drugs, remember?
They were trying to destroy it when we arrived. Hannah's got all the evidence we need in the other rover.
I've got the bodies in this one.
Have you asked them about the pilot?
Well, they seem very reluctant to talk about anything apart from their rights. Oh, yeah, they're making a lot of very pompous noises about their rights.
Well, they do have them, Colin.
Oh, yeah. These people who get rich through making designer drugs and selling them to groundsiders with a death wish. They, them scumbags like that, have got their rights.
Yeah, well, maybe they'll talk more when you get them back here.
Oh, I think they're going to talk before that. In fact, I have the definite feeling they're going to open their hearts to me very soon.
If not, we're gonna have to do it for them. Isn't that right, lads?
All right then, Colin, but do try to make it look like an accent this time, won't you? It does make the paperwork so considerably more simple.
Accident? What does he mean, accident?
What do you suggest?
Faulty backpack?
How about two faulty backpacks?
Yes, all right. All right, two faulty backpacks, yes. They do say that trouble comes in twos.
Screen off.
Threes, actually. Trouble? It comes in threes, is what they say.
Can I help you?
My name is Susan Caxton. Can I assume what I just heard was meant to be humorous?
Assume away, Miss Caxton. After all, isn't that what the press normally do?
Then you weren't threatening the lives of two prisoners, are they?
Well, we've just arrested two research chemists who have a nifty little sideline in drugs manufacture. They've been making a whole lot of synthetics, which they've been smuggling back to Earth for sale.
And this is a justification for making them frightened for their lives.
Oh, well, if it was down to me, I'd make them frightened for the more valued parts of their anatomy. Their lives would be the least of their problems.
You clearly don't subscribe to the idea that if you deny one man his rights, then no man is safe.
Well, I have subscribed to one or two drug rehabilitation centers in my time. If that's any help, what can I do for you, Miss Caxton?
I was looking for directions.
Oh, directions? Oh, yes, I'm good at those. And the time. If you want to know the time, then I'm your man.
And there's a Dr. Andrew Philpott somewhere on the base. Can you tell me where he is?
I would estimate that we are perhaps an hour behind you.
Fine. Listen, Anna, if you see any hitchhikers, don't pick them up.
Hitchhikers? What are you talking about? Did you say hitchhikers, Colin?
Yeah, it's just that my two passengers have decided to go for a bit of a walk. Think things over.
You're mad. You're miles away from anywhere.
Well, all right, so it's quite a long walk. Thing is, I don't want you picking them up. Do you understand me, Anna?
Yes. I was taught never to accept or give lifts.
Very sensible.
You're bluffing.
Am I? You see, the thing is, Anna, these two blokes are not the sort of passengers that a well-brought-up young star cop should be travelling with.
Tell me what's wrong with them.
Very poor conversationalists. They don't seem to want to talk about any of the things that I want to talk about.
I see.
So you'll leave them, then?
Even if they are dying for a lift.
Oh, they will be. Screen off. All right, lads. Walkies.
So they couldn't wait to tell Davis all about it, the whole shebang.
And the dead girl wasn't part of it?
Just a freelance pilot. Swore she knew nothing about the drugs.
And Larwood's dead man wasn't part of it either?
Never heard of him. Drugs, men, sculptors, dead pilots. How many cases have we got going on here?
Well, look, why don't you concentrate on the Martian business and leave this one to me?
Patience, Kenzie, patience. Your time will come. Well, 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 what's this, a temper tantrum? Just because your colleague, Miss Caxton, has an interview with the mysterious Dr. Philpott.
To what do I owe the pleasure of this visit, Commander?
Why didn't you report this?
I was going to.
After you'd cleaned up.
We thought it was time you told us what you know about the Martian.
You know, I'm beginning seriously to regret reporting that.
Not as seriously as you're going to.
Anything missing?
Nothing.
I suppose you don't have any idea what they were looking for.
None.
You know, the other two people to whom this happened just recently, they're being pretty closed-mouthed about it.
Oh, really?
Yes. They're both dead. Well, if you change your mind, Mr. Larwood, you'll know where to find us.
I'll catch up with you, Nathan.
Okay.
Okay, Daniel, you just changed your mind.
I think it's more likely that you just lost yours.
Yep. With the Martian due any time now, you don't want to leave the field entirely free for the delicious Miss Caxton, do you?
Oh, come on, sweetheart, you haven't got the power.
Yeah? I think I could make a pretty good case to get you sent back to Earth before the story breaks.
Oh, yeah? On what charge?
Illegal possession of alcohol.
Oh, you bitch.
I had to grow up sometime, Danny boy.
The
two pilots were connected. Now, she made the first contact. Apparently, they were peddling a picture of the Martian.
A picture of the Martian?
Yeah, well, that was the information that Larwood had. Now, he thought it was probably a hoax,
yes,
but
he couldn't pass up the chance that it wasn't. Well, neither can somebody else by the looks of things.
There's one other thing.
Let's hear it.
Well, the man wasn't dead when Larwood approached him, and he spoke.
Jeez. What did he say?
Well, nothing that made any sense, apparently. Just, well, I do something.
I do?
Yeah, well, I demand, I decide. I mean, it could have been any damn thing.
Is this all the information that your friend is withholding?
He's not a friend, Nate.
Just hold that thought, will you?
This is the base coordinator's office.
I have the use of it.
It'll be ideal for our purposes.
You do appreciate, of course, that I'm not expecting any surprises in this interview, Susan?
Is it possible to expect a surprise, Dr. Philpott?
Don't chop logic with me.
Let's just recap, then. I shall ask you about the deal which the Holdy Museum has made to buy the Martian.
You won't mention any figures, of course.
An undisclosed sum. I shall express surprise, however, at the whole idea. I mean, can you really buy a Martian? That sort of thing.
And you will then give me an opportunity to explain that the museum intends to make it available to the scientific community without condition or delay.
Not quite without condition. I mean, nobody else is allowed to see it, are they?
Once the world's research scientists have completed their work, then it'll be put on display at the museum.
But until then, it remains firmly under wraps. In fact, the entire deal depends on that. Or have I misunderstood?
No. You've understood perfectly.
Not quite perfectly, Doctor. Your museum...
It's hardly my museum.
The museum you work for doesn't exactly have a cash flow problem, does it? Why are you insisting on the exclusive rights to display and publication? The Holdy doesn't really need the money that will generate, do they?
It's precisely for that reason that the Holdy is the ideal guardian. We can ensure that the Martian is not the subject of tawdry exploitation, that it is treated with proper dignity.
I think that will probably be an appropriate note to end on. Any problems with that?
None that I can see.
It's obviously a computer foul-up, either at the Martian end or just possibly here.
You sure about this?
I look sure about anything. Mars says that those two were pilot and co-pilot of a freighter which, according to Mars, is still en route.
Which is a physical impossibility.
So they must have been flying a different freighter which left sometime before the one the computer says they were flying.
In other words, you've got a lost freighter. Was that accidental or deliberate, would you say?
Could be either. Believe me, we've made bigger cock-ups than that when we've been quiet.
You know what? I believe you. Thanks. Listen, have you had a break-in recently?
Not easy to tell in here. Although, oddly enough, I did have the feeling that somebody had been rummaging around. How do you know?
Let's just say I think you're on a list. There aren't many other places left.
What did you say?
I don't know. There's a pattern emerging here somewhere. God knows what it is. Kenzie, I want you to night watch that shuttle wreckage for me.
What the hell for?
Just do it, will you?
Why me?
Because everyone else is busy.
Yeah, or on a rest break, which is what I could
do. You prefer to be doing the paperwork on the drugs case?
No,
I can make sure.
No, okay. I just can't see the point in guarding a whole heap of junk. I mean, why would anyone want to bother with it?
The question's not why, Kenzie, it's who. Go on your bike.
Nathan, that expression went out 40 years ago.
Under arrest.
I'm sorry, Nathan. I wasn't expecting it.
Well, why the hell not?
Because I don't suppose I really thought anyone would show.
Oh, Kenzie. When will you ever learn to listen?
Do you have any idea who it was?
No, I didn't see them.
Still, no real harm done, I suppose.
Thanks a lot.
Excepting now they know for sure that we're onto them, whoever they may be.
It would be nice to know we were.
Yeah, wouldn't it?
Yeah. So what's your next move?
Well, it's more a case of what your next move will be. A few hours' time, I'm on Lucifer 1. Mars.
Already? Has she finished loading them?
Very nearly. Why, will you miss me?
Understand it, Dr. Philpott. There are at least 6 universities who have the legitimate right to view the Martian.
There are a number of separate scientific communities who will have to be given access, it's true.
So it may be years before the public gets to see it.
It's possible.
Anything's
Tell
possible
me, Doctor,
if you're wealthy enough.
Why are you insisting on the exclusive rights to
even the rich have to die?
The whole thing doesn't really need the money that will generate, do they?
Look, I was set aside to everyone else, and I couldn't seem to find it.
I'm not very big on farewells.
We can ensure that the Martian is not the subject of tawdry exploitation.
Take care of yourself.
That it is treated with proper dignity.
May it give us
a
hand.
But surely, Doctor, we're not talking about a living creature, are we?
Look after yourself.
Look, I've left it to David to appoint a second in command when he returns.
You won't be gone that long, will you?
Though, let me offer you this thought. It is not only the living.
Lucifer 1 lifts into its fueling orbit very
You're
soon.
You're being an expert on ancient cultures. I can understand how you
Nathan.
Might feel like that.
Yes, Box.
Dr. Philpott, thank you for talking to me.
Thank you.
This is Susan Caxton for Cosmopolitan News and all affiliates on Moonbase.
On Vector 27. Have a good flight. Oh, there's a message here from the StarCops headquarters for your passenger, Commander Spring. It reads, "Watch out for the little green men."
As yet, no one knows what really happened. The freighter exploded without warning, killing everyone on board.
Operations is overstretched, undermanned, underfunded. Something had to go sooner or later.
Were corners being cut?
And all this little green man crap that you people have stirred up hasn't helped.
But in safety, for example, would you say that corners had been cut?
Corners? I'd say whole bloody streets had been eliminated.
At least she's honest.
Among the dead was Commander
Screen
Nathan
off.
Spring.
I can't believe this.
Well, I can believe it. It's dangerous out here. I hadn't you noticed.
He shouldn't have been on that flight. It wasn't necessary.
What the hell does it matter whether it was necessary or not? The man's dead, for Christ's sake.
I can't see. I can't tell you how sorry I am.
Yeah, well, don't bother to try.
Tell me about the Martian.
The Martian?
The one that's coming to Moonbase.
You must forgive me. I've only just returned from Earth. I must be shuttle-legged. What has this to do with Commander Spring's death?
Because the last case Nathan wanted solved before he died was how come two pilots turned up on Moonbase when they should have been flying a freighter from Mars.
You must ask them.
They're both dead.
Both? It was agreed at the outset that Russian scientists would be the first to examine the find.
Well, no problems keeping it under wraps while your people had it. It must have suited everyone perfectly.
As it was to come to the moon first, and I was to act as go-between, it seemed natural. We knew that if the press realized that it had already been brought from Mars, we'd never keep them at bay.
Which is why you left it in the grounded freighter.
What could be safer?
You've never even seen the thing? Even though it's been on the moon the whole time.
Ah, there it is.
I hope you paid those pilots well. It took a hell of a risk putting that thing down.
Well, they expected to write it off. It was allowed for. What's that?
Your freighter just blew up.
Why? What could have happened?
Someone just destroyed your Martian.
Are you all right?
Nathan! Oh, Nathan, you're alive! You're alive, you're not dead!
No, not yet, I'm not, no!
Oh, we thought you were dead!
I'm sorry.
You're
I'm
supposed
sorry.
To be dead! Why didn't you tell
I'm
us
sorry.
You weren't dead?
Go!
Oh, tell
I'll
us!
Explain later!
You in pain, Larwood?
Yes.
Well, I'm glad to hear it. If you'd shared your thoughts with us earlier, those people on that freighter might still be alive. Do you realize that? What are you doing here?
I came for the picture. It had to be in the effect of the dead girl.
How did you work that out?
Kenzie, that shuttle pilot, she was carrying two IDs, remember?
Yeah.
Well, that's what his dying friend was trying to tell him. Not I denounce or I declare, but simply ID.
Yeah,
the picture was hidden in the second ID.
Have you seen it?
No, not yet. I've got it in Box's projection unit.
Give me the picture!
Oh. All right, Phil, hold it there, hold it there!
Hey, hey, hey.
Come on, Commander.
Put the gun down, he's got the fuse in his hand.
I'll take us all out if I have to. Come on, Commander.
All right, here. Take the box. Easy, easy.
How do I get the picture out?
Relax, Philpott. It's just, it's a very awkward little box. Maximum alarm!
Get down! Get down! Get down!
You would have done it, wouldn't you?
Sir. Nathan. What the hell is happening?
All right. All right, let's find out. Box. Projection.
That's the picture of the supposed Martian.
Evidence that there was once intelligent life on another planet. Crap.
But it's a Mayan sculpture.
Oh, that was the clever touch. There have been all sorts of theories about the Mayans being contacted by space travelers. You must have come across them. Yeah. Are the ancient gods really astronauts?
It's fantastic, isn't it? He took a genuinely old and valuable artifact. He got it smuggled to Mars.
There it was buried. He got his accomplice to discover it. World-shattering discovery. That Martians had visited the Earth and taken man culture back home with them. Yeah. Then they both clean up on what's now a genuinely old and priceless Martian artifact.
The whole thing's a con.
Yeah.
Yeah. A scheme to swindle the whole Holdia quite a lot of money.
That's the story you were after in the first place.
That's right, pal.
How did you hear about that?
Oh, I heard about the decision to purchase through the museum's trustees. So I did some background on the curators and found one of them had a personal connection with the Martian colonies. A cousin married to a surveyor.
That's all you had to go on?
Oh, major scandals have broken unless.
How did you hear about the picture?
The pilot offered it to me, too.
So you killed him. Then you realized it was all going wrong, didn't you? So you had to destroy all the evidence. With it, you destroyed innocent lives. All that remained was this picture. If you keep us inside, how do you expect us to do our job?
I just couldn't trust us.
I'm sorry, I didn't have time. I changed my mind at the last moment.
What, you'd figured it out, what?
Look, it all came together in that interview with Caxton when he talked about being an expert in ancient culture.
You couldn't tell us, though. Why?
After the explosion, it was unfair to keep us in ignorance.
Yeah, well, he wanted to use it to flush Philpott out into the open.
Yeah, Kenzie's right. I just thought he was more likely to come and search here if he thought that you were all... If he thought you were all in a state of shock.
Oh, come on.
We were.
You? You were still prowling around looking for a fight.
Yeah, well, shock makes me aggressive.
Yeah? What doesn't?
We wasted a lot of time trying to figure out a replacement for you.
Yeah, I guess it were choice was.
Which just leaves one question to answer. Anyone for Mars?